Well, let's try to understand what is complete binary tree. Now, a complete binary tree is a tree where all the levels are completely filled except the last level. Last level also should be filled from left to right. So that is, these are the two requirements for a complete binary tree. Now, if you do not go by definition, if you look at example, it will appear very simple what we are talking about. So see, this is a tree which we say it's a completely binary tree, complete binary tree, because A is filled, then A is left is filled, right is filled. So second level, at most two people would have come, and we see both the two children of A are there. Same way, B can have two children and both of them are there. C can have two children, both of them are there. Same way, D can have two children, E can have two children. F can also have two children, but F's left child is there, right child is not there. And if you see, this is the last level. At last level, we have nodes filled from left to right. And last level is not complete, but rest all the levels are having complete children. So this is a definition of complete binary tree. I hope you understand. And this forms the basis of our data structure that we are going to study. So let's do a simple exercise now, where you are given certain binary trees. If you see in the diagram, you have to identify which all of these are complete binary trees. We just saw the definition of complete binary tree, which said that all the levels should be completely filled and they should be filled from left to right order. So let's try to analyze whether A is a complete binary tree or not. So if we look at A, first level, there could have been only one child, only one node, and that is there. Second level, there could have been two children of root and both of them are there. Now this level, it can have left child, it can have right child. So it has left child, it has right child, they are there. But this guy doesn't have left and right child, and this is not the last level. So looking at this, we can simply say A is certainly not a complete binary tree, right? Same way, you yourself try to analyze whether B is a complete binary tree or not. So you can apply the same concept. You can pause the video for a short while and just start thinking whether B is a complete binary tree or not. Let's move to C now and see whether C is a complete binary tree or not. So again, you start looking at first level, there is one child. Second level, there are two. Third level, there are, ideally there should have been four, but there are three. So you can make a judgment whether this is a complete binary tree or not. Same way, let's move on to D and see whether D is a complete binary tree. 0 has two children, 1 has two children, 2 has two children, 3 has two children, 4, 5, 6. So all of them have two children each. Last level also is completely filled. So again, make a judgment whether this is a complete binary tree or not. And I'll show the answer. I'll show the answer towards the end, which will tell you. So you can tally your answer with that answer and figure out whether you understood the concept of complete binary tree or not. Same way, try to pause the video and try to look at whether E is a complete binary tree or not. Well, I guess you would have figured out your answers. So if we go by that, C is not a complete binary tree, because we see at third level, we do not have all the children. Like, this is a missing child. And D is a complete binary tree. E is not a complete binary tree, because in E, if we see at this level, all the children are there, but last level, this has left and right children missing. So ideally, the definition said the last level should have left to right filling. And here, this is filled, but left is still blank. So if we look at the answers, only B and D out of all these trees are complete binary trees.